on his track pants.
What's happening, Captain? This is your boy CB Hunts, and yes, what you see before you is the masterpiece Transformers. I think this is a version 2 Bumblebee. Man, I had this in like in the pile of figures I'm supposed to do reviews. I've been holding this off for a while because y'all know me, I hate transforming these bad boys. And no, I will not be doing a transforming part of this video.
Damn right.
Other people that have done that, I'm just gonna show off him in his car mode and his actual robot mode. But if you see him in a box, y'all know me, I'm an old school type of person. I love the original 80s Transformers. You see, he looks like the actual Bumblebee from the show. See, the box is like the year 35 edition. This bad boy look clean. The box shows off the car, how it looks. Back of the box show all the stuff it comes with, but it's mainly like in Japanese, so I can't really read what's all in it, but everything looks nice. So the other side, show him in his actual robot form. And when we get back, because I know in these boxes, like, they used to have them, when you, like, get these Transformers, they'd be already in robot mode. But now they're starting to put them in vehicle mode first. And I already know, since a homeboy of mine, Sean, he has this already. He told me, bruh, it's kind of hard.
He ain't lying.
I said, all right. So, when we take this out of the box, we're going to look at what all it comes with. And also in as well. Now, I'm going to hold off on what it comes with when I transform it into a robot. But for now, we're going to show him off in his vehicle form as he comes out the box. When we get back, we will do that. And now, as you can see, Bumblebee in his vehicle form, just like I said, when it comes out the box. Oh man, I'm getting in the old school feels right now.
He ain't lying.
This look exactly like the car. I think it's an 80 something Volkswagen. And the details on this looks amazing. It looks absolutely off the chain. You can tell by how it's made, and you see all the parts inside the car. Oh, this is gonna take me a while to do this. I might put wherever I finish, I might put like a actual time stamped how long it took me, because I know it's gonna be difficult. But hey, wanted it, I have to do it. But look at the detail on this mug, man. The sheen on this, the color scheme, because the way it looks on camera and the way in my hand, on camera it looks like extremely bright, but the car is like a little bit more a dark yellow. So kind of like how that looks to the underside of Bumblebee and everything. And I think these are like, wait, are they? No. I thought they were like rubber tires, but it's not. So I'm gonna go take a few pictures in car mode, so I won't leave that out. And I will be back. Don't know how long. I'll be back with him in robot mode. And now we're back. Bumblebee already transformed. It didn't really take me too long. It had a little few little hiccups here and there, but he's already done it, and he looks fantastic.
Damn right.
Oh my god, this is, like, I don't have the other version of Bumblebee, the version 1, what's the name that they had? I didn't order that one. I was about to until they said something about him. So I held back and I sat there waiting for him, and I'm kind of glad I did. But before we get to Bumblebee himself, we're going to get with everything he comes with. And for this here is his little icing that he got for the car mode. He got, like, I love New York. Looks tight. I like how it comes with a little sign right there. That's what comes with that one. And it also comes with his gun. It comes with, and it has a little peg where his hand goes. You can put it in either side, either hand. And I kind of like how it looks. It's all green plastic. It's like a all gray plastic. Like how that looks. And along with that gun comes with a effect. It's clear orange. As you can see, you can put it on the actual gun. Oop, drop the gun. Okay. Now I think I probably hit the camera too. I'm gonna have to see that. Okay, drop the blast effect. What is going on today? let me put this on here behind. Okay, there you go. How it looks with the blast effects. So I kind of like how that looks. When I put on my shelf, I will not be having this on here though. So, but how it looks, I will take some like real good pictures with it. Take that off. And with the different faces that he has his, like, big smiling face. Kind of like how that looks. Shows him happy. Everything else, just like a masterpiece figure. You go under the head, pulls out, and there's a little piece that goes on the face. Shows when you actually, plug it in. And the other face that it comes with, more like a smiling face, but like a little small smile. He always smiled a lot on the actual show. So about the camera not being focused too much. I don't know why it's been like that. So I like how this looks here. Looks really nice. Same thing. Other side. Helps eggs in. And up next is Spike. With this Spike here, he comes with a lot of articulation. He's extremely small though. Very small. Got a little articulation in the arms. Can raise up as much. You can see face. He can turn his head to left. Right, he does have a little rustling, but don't really turn as much. Legs can go up really high, kicks, goes back at the camera. Sorry about that, y'all. Little splits, knees bend. So he got a nice, a good articulation to him, but you gotta be careful though. The limbs will come off very easily.
He ain't lying.
But not the front, it will come back on. Like you see, pops off extremely easy. You can just snap it right back on. Hey. But for him, he's good for like taking pictures. I would not be having him on my shelf. Cause I'm afraid he might fall behind my shelf or fall, and I might end up losing him. But But I'm kind of happy that we have him. I have another spike that came with Optimus Prime, but it's a spike with his helmet on. I should have pulled him out, but like everything's all already put up already, like weighed, like in my closet. So I didn't feel like going through all that. But yeah, but he's the same one, but he has his hard hat on. So I like that. Now we get back. We'll be talking about the bad boy himself, Bumblebee. And now we will take a look at Bumblebee. He looks absolutely, sorry if I hit the camera again. Yeah, I'm just hitting everything today. He looks absolutely amazing. The way this is, the way he looks, it's like cartoon accurate to the T. Way they got the smile, the little smile, that smear you have to the Autobot sign on his chest, squares of the shoulders. It looks absolutely amazing. Only thing is like the difference because of the back way it transformed. I've seen people transform and thanks to how you say his name, Autonomous. I watched his video on this one to do like transform him. A big he went like a little too fast for me.
You ain't lying.
And like some of the steps he skipped, I had to kind of figure out on my own like with the legs. But hey, I got it done. But everything looks nice. The way he looks is like fantastic, man. Details for the like for the cartoon is like crazy intense. Like I like the how that looks. I can't wait to take some pictures of everybody. Yeah, I like it a lot. Next with Bumblebee, we're gonna show off a little bit of articulation. Even though he don't got as much as his other counterparts, but he can look up. The little hinge he got there, he can look up extremely well. So he can look left about that far, look right even a little bit farther. With the hinges he got, he does have a butterfly point right here, so he can move the arms in if need be. And so with this way, he can bend. Arms can go out. Gotta be careful because it's stiff. Arms can raise up. Careful, I don't want to break them. Raise up this high. So yeah, it does have some. He does have some range. Take it off camera real quick so I can bend the arms. Show more. Cause the one arm is kind of stiff. One arm is fine. One arm kind of stiff. I don't mind my action figures being stiff. That means the arm not gonna fall down, or stuff not gonna fall down. Like when it's on shelf as much. I don't mind them being stiff. But too loose, nah. Stiff, I don't mind. So got the arms back down, and he does have extra. Extra articulation in the under part of the arm on this side here. So he got the extra turn. As you can see, he has a single elbow, but it does bend extremely well. His both hands open up, so you'll be able to hold his gun. See the open with the peg. Hold his gun. Does not have no waist articulation, but the way his legs are designed, you have extremely good movement. So the legs can go this high up. As you can see, has the bend in the knee right there. So, and he does do the splits extremely well. And he skirts, and he does have like a bend in the knee and the extra movement in this part of the hip as well, so he can bend up even higher. So legs can just go extremely high. So I kind of like that. And you see when you move, the skirt moves as well. I like how that looks. Goes right back. And bend the knee that far back. Because the way the designs are, I'm just hitting the camera like crazy today. So sorry about that, y'all. And his feet, he does have like a little ankle pivot. But it don't turn. But don't turn as much. So you have to like turn the actual leg to make it turn. But all in all, it's a good figure. I like how he looks. And look, he's just awesome. And now we're going to see a little size comparisons where how he stacks up next to his other he won the castmates. First one he stacked, we'll see how he stacks up to, is the Fan Toys Starscream, aka what's the name? Edier. Yeah, he stays like a nice height between them two. I kind of like how it looks. And yes, the head on this Fantoid is not the original head that it comes with. I've used the head, the Starscream head that actually comes with my Optimus because I kind of like how the head looks more like Starscream. The other head, the face was a little too dark, so I like this one here like much, much better. And up next, you see how he stacks up next to Fan Toys. As, aka, I think it's Ambeat, yeah, but you know me, I'm gonna call him Jazz. But I like how they look. It stacks up like how the height is on the actual show. I'm hoping Masterpiece makes a Jazz and keep remaking everybody else, but I want them to make a like a old school figure of him. We need one of him. And up next, we see how he stacks up to Masterpiece Agatron. You see how he towers over Bumblebee, which he should. I kind of like how they got him like a real accurate like height, how it is on the cartoon. So trust me, having all these on my shelf, it hits me in the old school feels, man. Like I'm just loving it all. And last but not least, you see how he stacks up to Masterpiece MP44 version 3 Optimus Prime. You know, I had MP10, he broke, so yeah, I was kind of mad with all that. The arm just it came off, but at the same time that happened, like I got him, and I, you know, from the view from this dude, I was ecstatic. But yeah, but having him next to Bumblebee on the actual shelf, it's gonna be off the chain. And this is my review of the MP45 Masterpiece Bumblebee. Hope y'all enjoyed my review. I apologize about the stuttering. I don't mean when I get a certain figure or a certain thing that old school like this, I get excited, I start to stutter a lot, and I apologize for that. But so, hope y'all enjoy it. Trust me, I will be taking pictures of these, and I'll be putting them on my Instagram. Y'all want to see how they look. Here go the intro right here. I will be putting links down below to my other stuff too as well. So if y'all like, comment, and subscribe. This is your boy CB Hunts, and I'll be back in the next one. Peace.